Well, I don't know what you'd call this. I guess a little bit of an update for the post-breakout attempt that didn't go well. I'm still kind of like in that fluid, I mean, I'm jumping out of sequence or whatever because I haven't even, you know, no one else has moved, so on and so forth. Yet again, I'm just trying to play up the narrative here, so... What a God, man, am I ever giving it to Brusilov in my universe? This is ridiculous. Well, tough. So these guys are going to be, as far as I know, they're going to surrender, and I'm going to get them to surrender, excuse me, at the end of this turn. And it'll, you know, just be counted up as the demoralization points. Then these guys are not going to move this turn because that they were part of that combat and the breakout attempt, so they're not going to move. I'm going to let Brusilov move just one hex over, but his days are over. He's going to be kind of like the same thing that happened with Bomb Ermoli, I do believe, if I remember correctly, the Second Army commander's name here after it got actually ironically, isn't that weird that it was Brusilov that wiped out the Austrian Second Army in my world, and well, historically it was the Third. So talk about weird twists of fate, because in real life Brusilov crushed the Austrian Third Army, got rewarded for it, and in my world he crushed the Austrian Second Army. That army commander got relegated to essentially desk duty, basically doing right now. It's a recombination supply transfer center. That's basically what he's doing. excuse me. And then in my world, as we know, Brusilov was fantastic. I mean, I don't think we can see it. Let's hold on. I can zoom out. But just remember how far out he was. Oops. They were over here. He was responsible for the destruction of the 97th, in a way. It was me that sent them out there against four divisions. I never should have done that. But anyways, I wouldn't have done that if he wasn't there, is what I'm saying. So let's zoom back in. So Brusilov was way the heck over here, got all the way to here. Maybe got a bit greedy. I was also looking at some of his tactics, supposedly, and I don't think I played him very well. As in, he probably would not have done this little thing of, he would have probably, from what I've been reading and so on and so forth, he would have probably not just concentrated his attack in that one spot. He probably would have, originally what I wanted to do, and I didn't do it, which is ironic, which is probably, he just didn't have a lot of supply, and that's the way I did. I adapted it for this game, I guess you could say. And, you know, we concentrated here, made the breakthrough across the river. But I think he would have, attacked across a little bit, wider front, not just so whatever. Anyways, that's the way it goes. So he'll move on over here, will be relegated to desk duty, and, all these are now going to be, under Third Army, command. Everybody's going to be under Third Army command. Actually, he's going to have to take, his instructions from Ruzsky, the Russian Third Army commander, and that's just the way it goes. So that's it. He's going to be sent over here, limping his way back towards here, and just basically being a recombination distribution center. And yeah, that's it. And if I, you know, need to spread some supply points over to here, I guess, but. Yeah, it'll be just like pressing the button, like the hitting the return key. There's going to be no decision making. Gosh, what a weird world. All right, that's it.